Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is your brother Nafis Abu Zayd. And today's reminder is addressed towards the non-believers, those who do not believe that the Qur'an was sent down by Allah Jalla wa Ala, that the Qur'an was revealed by Allah, those who doubt in the mission of Muhammad Ibn Abdullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wa Ala Alihi Wa Sahbihi Wa Sallam. For you non-believers, your Lord, Allah, the Almighty, has challenged you within His book in five different places and five different verses to produce, to bring forth anything remotely close or like the Quran, one verse, one surah, 10 surahs, if you doubt that which Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with. And I want you to take true consideration and ponder and reflect sincerely if you doubt that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have come with the Quran from Allah. The first verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he challenges mankind. He says, wa in kuntum fi raybin mimma nazzalna ala 'abdina fa'tu bi suratin min mithlihi wad'u shuhada'akum min dunillahi in kuntum sadiqin fa in lam taf'alu وَلَن تَفْعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. And these two verses that comes in the second surah of the Quran, which is known as Surah Baqarah of the Cow, Allah Jalla wa Ala, He addresses mankind. He said, if you are truly in doubt as to what we have revealed to our servant, meaning Muhammad, the Arab who was born 570 AD, if you are in doubt to that which he came with, then produce a surah like it and call on your witnesses besides Allah if you are indeed truthful. It had been 1436 years and this challenge has yet to be met from anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he continues. He said, and if you cannot, and you will never be able to do so, then fear the fire whose thews are men and stones, and has been prepared for those who are deniers, those who are disbelievers, those who are ingrates. Then Allah Jalla wa Ala, he says in another surah, which is the 10th surah, Surah Yunus, named after the prophet Jonah, Allah says in this surah, challenging mankind again, Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ أَنْ يُفْتَرَى مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. And it is not such that this Quran can be produced from other than Allah Jalla wa Ala, وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. However, it is a confirmation of that which came before it, meaning those previous books that were revealed from Allah Jalla wa Ala, such as the Torah and the Injil that was given to Isa ibn Maryam, Isa the son of Mary, and the Zabur that was given to Dawood alayhi salatu wassalam. Allah said, وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ. It is an explanation of the book. مِنْ رَبِّهِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, wherein there is no doubt from the Lord in all that exists. أَمْ يَكُولُونَ افْتَرَى, do they say that he, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, has forged it, he has made it up, he has invented. قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ وَدْعُوا مَنْ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, do they say that he, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, has forged it, he has made it up, he has invented, and he has made this thing, then say to them, O Muhammad, produce a surah like it, just one chapter like it, and call on whoever you want to call, you are able to, besides Allah, if you are indeed truthful. Allah Jalla wa Ala addressing them in another surah, which is the surah known as the 11th surah, the 11th chapter of the Quran, which is known as Surah Hud, named after the Prophet Hud. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, Am yakulun aftara? Do they say he, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, has forged it? He has made it up. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala continues, he said, Kul fa'tu bi ashri suwarin mithlihi muftarayatin wad'u man istata'tum min dunillahi in kuntum sadiqin fa'in lam yastajibu lakum fa'lamu anna ma unzila bi'ilmillah wa an la ilaha illa hu fahal antum muslimun. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he said in these following verses, he said that if do they say that? He said, do they say that he, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, has forged it? Then produce 10 chapters, surahs just like it, and call whomsoever you will, or you are able to besides Allah, if you are indeed truthful. And if they are not able to answer you, if the non-believers are not able to answer you, O Muslims, then know that this has been revealed, meaning the Quran, been revealed and sent down with the knowledge of Allah, and that none has the right to be worshipped except He. That Allah Jalla wa Ala is the true deity deserving of being worshipped. And fahal antum muslimun, Allah said, then will you not surrender unto Him? Will you not then be Muslims? And last but not least, Allah Jalla wa Ala, He mentioned the 17th chapter of the Quran, which is known as Surah Al-Isra. And it's interesting enough, the ascension, the mi'raj of the Prophet from Mecca to the heavens, taken up to the seven heavens, which was denied by the disbelievers during his time, from the Quraysh and other than them, from the Arabs, who denied that the Prophet was actually taken up. And he had traveled from Mecca to Jerusalem in a short time, only a day, when the travel was longer than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, addressing mankind's indigents, those created beings from the unseen world, that Allah have created them like He had created the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kulla innijatama'atil insu wal jannu an ya'tu bi mithli hadha al-Quran. Say, if all of the mankind and the jinns was to come together to produce the like of this Quran, la ya'tuna bi mithlihi, they will still be unable to produce it. وَلَوْ كَانُوا بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا, even if they was to help one another and try to produce it. This shows the inability that both mankind and the jinns have in producing the likes of this Quran. And these five verses, I would like for the non-believer to sincerely ponder and reflect upon it, and look that since the Quran has been revealed 1436 years ago from an illiterate Arab who cannot read nor write, and the Quran have yet not been changed, so much so that you can take a person from every ethnicity or from every language, a person of a group of people, whether he's from Russia, China, whether he's from Africa, whether he's from Malaysia, wherever place you want to take them, and you was to place them in a room and they don't know any language but the language that they know, however they know the Quran, if you was to tell them to recite, it would be all same. Whereas though if you want to produce the same Quran again, but they can write down, they will all have it from their breast, and it will be no harf, one letter, one harakah, one vowel would not be changed. Showing you the miracle of the Quran. Showing you that the Quran is not produced by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who, by the way, his name is only mentioned 4 times in the Quran, and Isa alayhi salam is mentioned 25 times, 11 times on a different scale. And also it mentioned the other times on a different scale by the permission of Allah. This is your brother Nafis Abu Zayd, reporting to you from the House of Amber, waking up inshallah and giving a brief reminder to the non-believers. It's time for you to wake up and to accept Islam before it's too late, before Allah Jalla wa Ala caused your soul to come back, or before He sent Isa Ibn Umariyyah back. You will not have the time then to accept Islam. We urge you sincerely to read the Quran, the last revealed revelation to mankind that abrogates all of the previous revelations, except Islam, except Muhammad as your messenger, as the last and final messenger, and you will be granted salvation, and you will be granted safety by the permission of Allah. Jazakallah khair.